and get heroin. That was an interesting conversation. And my guest is joining me right now. Hello, how are you doing?
Yes, hi, how are you?
I'm doing real good, and thank you for joining me on the show this evening.
Well, thank you for inviting me.
Now, before we begin, I just want to make sure I pronounce your name correctly. Maybe I should have asked your agent beforehand, and that's my fault. But
no, this is way more fun. Let's do it this way.
Okay, so I got your name in front of me through your Twitter account. So I hope let me at least start with the first name. Is it Suji Lee?
No, nice try. It's Suhaley.
Suhaley, okay.
Suhaley, yes.
And how do you pronounce your last name?
Kendall.
Kendall, okay.
Yes.
Suhaley Kendall.
Yes.
Wow. That's a miracle. So I'm just calling you Suhaley then.
I love that, yes.
So, and you're from Brooklyn, New York. You're an actress.
Yeah.
What made you decide to get into acting? How did it all start off for you?
Let's see. I was a little girl, and I saw people on TV, and I said, that's what I want to do. And I've never wanted to do anything else. So I think that sometimes we're just meant to just do one thing. And I really believe that if you love something enough, you can make anything happen.
So what type of films or what type of film work for that matter do you prefer like doing the most? Are you more into the action, the drama, the romantic films? Like what type of film work do you enjoy doing the most?
I have done, well, what I like to work on is actually I would love in the future to play opposite what I always get cast as, which would be something like the bad girl or like the mischievous, control freak, or even like the shy girl, something crazy. But I like drama, and I like sci-fi, believe it or not. I like sci-fi thrillers. I like drama, and romantics are cute. Usually they're romantic comedies, but they're cute. But yeah, drama and sci-fi are really fun to work on.
I like the sound of that. Me as a fan of film, I like to watch action and comedy film. Like if you have some romantic on the side, among other things, then I'll watch it too. And what I like about film in particular is just how dedicated actors and actresses are, and how much hours they put in working on these scripts and the lines and things like that. It has to be a lot stressful for actors and actresses being on film, take after take, until you get the lines right or get the scene right. Like, how do you deal with the stress of being an actress, having to do take after take time and time all over again? I mean, it has to be stressful, right?
Stressful? No, it can be deflating. It can definitely take a toll on your hope and your faith sometimes. But, then once in a while you get these amazing opportunities where you do get a script, and the script is a great script. I just had one that was an actual sci-fi thriller. I just auditioned and it went incredibly well. I had amazing feedback, thank God. But it's and the script, I read the script 18 times before I went in the room, and I really broke down my character because it's a supporting lead. And when you go in a room and you're that well prepared, and in the room they say to you, wow, the choices you made were head on, they were straight on, they were amazing, and I'll see you at the callback, it's like, oh, thank you. Yeah, I just pretty much was so solid and I rocked it. And if you continue working on your craft, I still take classes till this day because it's what really keeps me going. And when I go in the room, yes, I have nerves, but I'm not the way I was a few years ago. Now I go in that room nervous because I can't wait to get the workout, not because, oh my God, am I going to mess up,
And you know, I could definitely understand, you know, how, I mean, it can be at times, but in the end, it's all about, you know, it's all about being on the same page with the director and knowing that actors and actresses, extras, etc., they are human. And sometimes you get the scene right. Sometimes it's going to take a few more takes than usual. But as far as, I guess it's just a matter of the director's patience. I mean, how much he or she's willing to wait in order to make sure the film, the movie is right. Because, you know, everybody want to, it's not the director wants to make sure the film is right. It's the people in front of the camera want to make sure that the movie is right.
Yeah. I mean, when you're talking about different mediums, you have theater, which you can take, you have any time from, you know, 2 weeks to a 2 month rehearsal time. So they get a lot of rehearsal time. When you're talking about film, it's okay because the director can go, can say, let's do it over, let's do it over, let's do it over, let's do it over. But when you're talking about something like TV, the reality of it is, it's because of the money, because of the time constraints. You really, really, when you're going to do TV, it's a lot quicker and a lot more demanding as far as even the director saying, oh, you're an actor, right? And you were brought in and you know how this medium works. And you know that you got to nail it at least on the second try. And if we don't, we got to keep moving because we have three more scenes to shoot just today. So, yeah, I mean, it's definitely something that if you're not someone that has been trained on the technical end of camera either, you're going to find yourself incredibly overwhelmed. Because you have the sound guy, the camera guy, the lighting guy, everybody coming up to you one at a time, giving you different directions. And you're standing there going, I have to take everything in that every person is saying, even if they're opposite. And you got to do that. You got to do that because then the director will remember you and he'll call you back. And he'll remember to work with you, which is what happens, really. You have a lot of directors that keep calling in the same actors. Why? Because they know that they're low maintenance in the sense of they're not going to have to potty train them, to say a better, lack of a better word.
That's quite an interesting analogy, potty train. just point that out.
Like I said, lack of a better word.
Yeah, for absolutely. We are days removed from the devastating passing of a talented actor and comedian in Robin Williams. That's been so much talked about him. He gave his own life. He committed suicide. He had Parkinson's disease, and prior to his tragic death, bottom line is, the man, and I didn't even know this, I guess because he hasn't been in the limelight for a long time. He had depression, and I guess he didn't get enough support from his family and friends or whatever, which led to him no longer being with us. So, what's your thoughts on his tragic passing, and do you have a favorite Robin Williams movie or character that he played?
Okay. I think that depression is a very, very common and serious thing. I don't think that it's something that just happens to some people. I know that, you know, we all go, I think, through our own little forms of depression, whether it be for work or family or money, which, you know, people get so depressed with the money, which is, you know, there was this quote from Gandhi where he basically says, you know, I don't understand men. I don't understand man. They stress to make money, then they get sick and they stress some more to make more money to get better. So it's really interesting. And how I feel about that is just that we all have our demons. And Robin Williams, as funny as he was to everyone else, I think that for a long time, even in the news, you heard things about him having, you know, just problems. And I didn't realize that his depression was that severe. But then again, why would I? You know, I'm not one of his close friends and I'm not a family member. And I would be surprised to know even if his close family knew. It is a very big loss, but, you know, every other Philip Seymour Hoffman. I mean, anyone else that we've lost is a big loss. And even not just celebrities, not just, you know, famous people. I think that a loss is big in any person because we're all human. I mean, Robin Williams made me laugh. talk about. I mean, he's just funny. I love Mork and Mindy. I mean, that's it. I mean, to create, because he created that character. You know, you get a script and you get a little bit from it, and the writer writes in what he wants. But the fact that you can make that your own and find your own quirkiness and your own stuff, and you can be pretty much a legend and just coming into the business, ah, good for him. And I hope, well, I should say I wish that he would have sought more help, because I think when we're depressed, we think there is no help, and there is. It's hard to see the light when you're that in such a dark place. But I hope that at least people now who are depressed and have seen what happens maybe can get help just from what has happened to him. Maybe that was his way of helping, in a very tragic way, of course.
I mean, some of my favorite Robin Williams movies he's ever done is Jumanji, Mrs. Doubtfire, yeah. And I believe he was on Aladdin as well. I mean, the man, he had a gift.
He did.
He was great. He was just so talented and just an incredible person, you know.
And his stand-up was hilarious.
Yeah, I mean, I barely have had a chance to see his stand-up. I just seen some of his movies.
Oh, man, it's great. It's classic. You really have to watch some of his stand-up stuff. Really, really great work. Just, you know, his voice even. Everything's just funny.
And rest in peace to Robin Williams. Yes. Thoughts and prayers go out to his family to close this matter, depression is something not to be handled alone. Get all the help that you can. All it takes is support to get it out of that depression. It may take a day, it may take a week, it may take a month, but all you need to avoid that further of depression is just support. And the more support you get, the better you get out of the depression. I think that's probably the only logical thing that you can
absolutely
do.
Absolutely.
So do you have any upcoming movies or theater?
I actually just this week two major things happened, and I am on hold for one, which is I can't talk about because disclosure. And I just got a call back for that sci-fi film, which would be a feature film. And I hope to be in that soon. And pilot season starting now, so I hope to be very, very busy. And did a couple of voiceovers, and I did a few commercials. And just, you know, my agents are helping me. And, hey, let's see what happens.
I'll definitely keep an eye on that sci-fi.
Thank you.
And for people that wants to learn more from your work or get in contact with you via social media, why don't you go ahead and promote your social media links and where can people learn more from your work?
I mean, you can Google me and you'll definitely find stuff there. And you can, my I'll even do Facebook. My Facebook account is just Sue Haley, my first name, Sujeilee dot Candelle. I'm sorry, take the dot out. Sorry, it's just Sue Haley Kendall. That's my Facebook. You can find me. And my Twitter, you're going to have to help me out here because I forgot which one is my Twitter with Instagram and all that. So which one is my Twitter again?
Is at Sue Haley Kendelle.
That's it.
So
daily at Sue Haley Kendall, yes.
So
and Instagram, just again, Sue Haley Kendall. If you just my name, because the first name is so rare, you can pretty much plug it into anything and it's just going to pop up.
Yes.
You can find out a lot on that stuff.
And I do want to point out that on the Twitter is that there's a picture, her main photo. She's got the look on her face, and she's pointing, you know, like a statue, and she got one of those things that you use to cook stuff. So That's her profile pic. Suhaili Kendall. Go follow her on Twitter. Support her on Facebook. And if you want to book her for films, interviews, theater, etc., go contact her agency at World Entertainment Agency at their website, worldentertainmentagency.com, one of the best agencies around. And
absolutely.
And you can book her there. And she'll do movies, she'll do theater work, she'll do interviews. She wants to make a name for herself, so, and she's from Brooklyn, so I had
and I'm bilingual.
Oh yeah, that too.
Which
yeah.
is awesome.
So now that you brought that up, bilingual and all, have you had a chance to do any film that require you to speak different languages?
Yes, I did. And one of my first films, I had to speak Spanish. I also did a soap opera in Spanish. So yeah, and a lot of commercials I've been in have been bilingual and voiceovers. So yeah.
Well, Suhaili,
been a ride so far.
Well, Suhaili, it was great chatting with you. And I want to thank you for your time, and thank you for not busting my chops for mispronouncing your name at times.
No, I get a little kick out of it. It's a little fun for me. And I want to say thank you for having me, and thank you for everyone listening. And, you know, let's see. Watch out for me. Fingers crossed.
Oh, and before I let you go, there's one favor I would like for you to do for me. And
sure.
So next Saturday is our 7-year anniversary show. And I've reaching out to former Chilling Guests, and I guess after this show is over, you'll be considered a former Chilling Guest. What I would like for you to do is give us a voice drop by congratulating us on the 7-year anniversary show. So what I want you to do is say your name, and right after you say your name, and I hope this is not too much of a voice drop for you to say, but all you got to do is just say your name, and after that, you say congratulations to Chilling with Jeff and Kenny C on his 7-year anniversary. That's pretty much all you have to say.
Yeah, sure. This is next week?
Yeah, this is for next week, and I will play this voice drop live on the air next week.
Suhaili Kendall, and congrats to Chilling with Jeff and Kenny C.
That's good. That was
That's
good.
That's it? You already yeah.
Well,
I could do it again. I could do it better.
Or better yet, you could do it in Spanish. I mean, I'll
why don't I do that? Why don't I do that?
Go
That's
out
even
here.
Better. Okay, I'm going to go now. Hola, soy Haley Kendall, y quiero dar las felicidades a Jeff y Kenny C. Con Chilling, con Jeff y Kenny C. Así que felicidades, que les deseo muy bien.
My, oh my, I like the sound of that. And again, thank you for your time, and best of success goes out to you.
Oh, likewise, thank you.
You have a good night.
All right, you too. Hugs and kisses. Ciao.
All right, that was our guest of the evening, Sue Hale, and she is awesome. She is a very...